Everything that lives has periods of birth, period of growth, period of fruitage, and decline. These periods are governed by the septimal law, which is relating to the number 7. The law of 7 governs the days of the week. It governs the phases of the moon, the harmonies of sand, light, heat, electricity, magnetism, and atomic structure. It governs the lives of individuals and of nations, and it dominates the activities of the commercial world. Those familiar with this circle will not be disturbed when things seem to go wrong, for they are fully assured that a higher law will invariably control all other laws, and that through an understanding and conscious operation of spiritual laws, they can convert every difficulties in their lives into blessings. Welcome to Success Digest, where we discuss and analyze those ingredients needed for your financial independence and live a glorious life. My name is Kayo Denrayton, the publisher of Success Digest video series and the CEO, Kenny's Consult Limited, a financial service firm that is based in London. Our discussion today is on wealth, a means, not an end. Your wealth, a means, not an end. A means is an instrumentality for accomplishing some end, while an end of a thing is the final result, the final destination, or the final manifestation, the final accomplishment. There's only three things which all mankind desires and which are necessary for his highest expression and complete development, and they are good health, enough wealth, and love. Those who possess all three, health, wealth, and love, find nothing else which can be added to their cup of happiness. But when we consider the small addition made by wealth to the happiness of the possessor, we find that true value consists not only in its accumulation, but in its exchange. It is good to have wealth, don't get me wrong, but its real value comes not in its accumulation, but in its exchange. Wealth is like salt. You don't enjoy salt by putting the chunk of it in your mouth or by storing it in a container. You enjoy the value of salt when it is spread over items like food to eat or items for preservation. Wealth is like that. It has to be spread. Wealth is a product of labor. It is capital. It is an effect and not a cause. A servant, not a master. It is a means, not an end. These features, which I just mentioned, give wealth the most acceptable definition of all useful and agreeable things which possess exchange value. It is this exchange value which is the predominant characteristic of wealth, and this exchange value makes it a medium for securing the things of real value whereby our ideas, our goals can be realized. The end can be reached. Hence, it is a means to reach that end and not the end itself. You don't need to get a shovel to shovel out darkness in a room. All you need to do is to switch on the light. Many of us chase shadow instead of reality. When we let in the light, there can be no darkness. And when there is abundance, there can be no poverty. If we know the truth, we cannot be deceived by error. When there is health, which means there is no disease. Do you know the definition I personally give to wealth? It is that wealth is ability to create, ability to make things happen, ability to manifest your ideas. When you bring into manifestation a thing that meets the need of people, they come for it knocking on your door. And since our lives comprise exchange of services, they pay for it. The remuneration that such service brings to you makes you rich. That's why you hear people say wealth of experience and not riches of experience. To become rich is the ultimate goal, the end of desire. But to bring this to pass, wealth, the ability to create, meets the need of people who now pay for your services, bringing you riches, which you desire. Your wealth, like I said, is a means to reach that end and not the end. There's this mistake of ignorance on the part of some people who confine their belief of wealth in terms of monetary aspects only. One of the definitions of wealth is an abundance of material possessions and resources. Financial resources is inclusive and not the absolute wealth. It also includes the sources of knowledge and experience. If your knowledge is vast and quantitative, When you apply such vast knowledge to the supply of the need of mankind, you will definitely become financially rich through the remuneration that will come to you. In fact, this is the way to obtain sustainable riches, and the reason is that riches that are bequeathed or that is obtained through Jacob, they fly away easily because of lack of ability of the possessor to add value to it. It is a simple logical process to obtain knowledge. Apply the knowledge obtained diligently and professionally and with honesty, and what you seek will start to run after you. If success is measured only by monetary viewpoint, consideration for peace of mind and ability to do will be unimportant. Money alone do not bring success. Success in its highest and noblest form calls for peace of mind and enjoyment and happiness. We come only to the man who has found the work that he likes best, the work that he loves. Analyze yourself and determine what your natural native ability best fits you to do. Engage in the work for which you are best suited by nature. Listen to this quotation, which demonstrates the pleasure in doing and not only in money aspect received. He will never suffer but live half life. He will never fail, has never strove or sought. He will never weep his finger to a laugh. He will never doubt, has never thought. The glory is in the doing and not in the trophy that is won at the end. Please listen to this. A man is most efficient and will work more quickly and easily succeed when engaged in the work that he loves, or work that he performs on behalf of some person whom he loves. Whenever the element of love enters into any task that one performs, the quality of the work becomes immediately improved and the quantity will increase, with that a corresponding increase in the fatigue caused by that work. Some years ago, a group of socialists organized a colony and purchased several hundred acres of land and started to work out an idea which they believe will give them greater happiness in life and fewer of the world worries, through a system that provides each person with the work at the sort of labor that he liked best. They agreed to pay no wages to anyone. Each person did the work he liked best, or that for which he might be best equipped. The product of their labor become the property of all. They produce their own dairies. They have their own brick-making machines, their own cattle, poultry, and all things needed in a community. They even have their own schools and publish their own newspaper. A foreign gentleman then joined this colony, and at his own request, he was placed at work in the newspaper publishing department. Very soon, he complained that he did not like the work, so he was changed and put to work on the farm to operate a tractor. He could only stand it for 2 days and again asked for transfer. He was assigned to the dairy but could not get along with the cows, so he again was changed. One by one, he tried every job in the colony but liked none of them. He was about to withdraw when someone happened to think of one job he has not tried, and that is brick making plant. He was given a wheelbarrow to put to work wheeling bricks from that plant and stacking them in piles. A week went by and there was no complaint. When asked if he liked the job, he just beamed with a smile and continued wheeling the bricks. The job suited the man. He worked alone at a task which called for no thought and placed no responsibility on him. He remained at the job until all the bricks had been wheeled and out and stacked. Then he withdrew from the colony. To him, the job he loved best had finished, and there's no reason to carry on with the colony. When a man is engaged in work that he loves, it is no hardship for him to do more work and better work than that for which he's even paid for. For this reason, every man owes it to himself to do his best to find the sort of work that he likes best. I have the perfect right to give this advice because this is my philosophy and the principle that I followed myself without having any reason to regret having done so. I need to say this. The man who engages in the work that he loves best does not always have the support in the choice of his closest friends and relatives. Seldom, if ever, can one hope to engage in the work one loves best without meeting with obstacles of some nature. Generally, the chief obstacles in the way of one engaged in the sort of work one loves best is that it may not be work that brings the greatest remuneration at the start. Nonetheless, there are two benefits that is accrued to he who engage in the sort of work he loves, which is first, he usually finds in such work the greatest of all rewards, which is happiness, and this is priceless. Secondly, his actual reward in monetary, when averaged over a long period of effort, is generally much greater, for the reason that labor which is performed in a spirit of love is usually greater in quantity and finer in quality than that which is performed solely for money. The most disastrous opposition to this second benefit, and I'm saying this without any intention of disrespect, come from someone's spouse. They are always in support of salaried position that will ensure a regular monthly income without consideration to happiness. I know I'm not going to be popular with this, but it is the truth. How will you become rich if you work only for money? All your efforts and aspirations will be on the remuneration that is coming to you at the expense of the quality of your service. Only quality service bring back the clients. The dancer that dances without awareness of being watched dances the best. Your worth is a means to an end and not the end itself. For a fuller and more comprehensive discussion on this important topic or any of my previous videos, feel free to contact us at Kenneth Consult Limited and allow us to discuss with you more enlightenment and ingredients needed for becoming financially independent. We are the financial experts that specializes in financial management. We will invest your fund on stock on financial instruments for you at the stock exchange and manage it for you thereafter. We also provide training in career and skill development, business and entrepreneurial development, business counseling and mentoring. Let us continue to travel together on this journey of success through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed, and not to be informed is to be deformed. My name is Remain Kayo Denrison, and I can be reached on 074-2794-2000 or 07951-775255. Better still, visit our website, kenneth consult limited.uk, kenneth consult limited.uk. If you are blessed by this video, please subscribe to it, share it and like. Also, visit our blog on YouTube for more of our videos. Please enjoy your success.
Welcome to Success Digest, where you obtain ingredients for your financial abundance and financial wellness and be fully financially independent. Let us travel together on this, our journey of success, through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed. Not to be informed is to be deformed. Success Digest leads you to financial independence.